Hello, everybody. My name is Zach, aka the Weather Gamer, bringing you another episode of Pokemon Fire Red. I'm not calling it a Nuzlocke anymore because I suck at Nuzlockes. I legit suck at Nuzlockes. And so, this is just gonna be a playthrough at this point. You can see the mons that are on the team. I've got Sparky, Zippo, and I've brought P1 Champ back on. I don't care about the others, I'm not gonna use them. I'm just doing a playthrough at this point. You guys can continue to watch if you want. If I get zero views on a huge chunk of these videos, then I'll stop the series, just like I did with Let's Go Pikachu. But I want to play the game for you guys. I got way too upset and salty. I don't want to have to restart every single time. I want to complete the games. So the easiest way to do that is just to the easiest way to do that is just to do a normal playthrough. I'll get into doing randomizers at some point. Of course he crit me. Whatever. Now I can't beat Charmander. Or beat Squirtle. Of course, it's a crit. Because that's just what it's going to be. And he doesn't get paired. So, whatever. Bring in your Squirtle. Try to beat him with P1. Not going to farm the nuggets. There's no point. It's just boring to watch anyways. And of course he's gonna withdraw and boost his and then lower mine. Yep, cool. Oh, this is so much fun. I hate Gary. I really do. Of course, that's not enough. This is gonna be crit. Nope. Okay, Squirtle died. This thing's only got teleport. So this thing easily dies. And that just leaves a Rattata. Cool. And now I can beat the Rattata. Couple embers to its face. And it's burned. That's nice. And Ember. This is how playing Pokemon used to be for me. Except it wasn't as rage-inducing because people weren't watching me. I used to just run headlong in and play over and 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 over again until I won. Didn't bother me. Cool. Red is not a chatty gossip, trust me. And heal. And continue forward. Continue the playthrough. I'm so done with Nuzlockes for now. If you were here for the Nuzlocke, I'm sorry. Not doing it anymore. I'm gonna play Pokemon the way I play Pokemon. Taking on the Nugget Bridge. four mons that should be, that should be a Butterfree. I will happily feast on it with Sparky. Stringshot. Sparky will get you again with a Thundershot. Great. Yeah, because you need a shot of electricity. Thundershock. Bye-bye. A crit. Cool. Alright, Sparky, level 15. Not you, little. Cheeky little. Yes, we're gonna switch. Zippo, your time to shine, buddy. Weedle. Ember, that should be a Beedrill. And it's gone. Metapod. Okay, so we're moving our way up. You at least let this one evolve to Metapod, even though it should be a Butterfree. Okay, we toasted your Metapod. Kakuna, so you are a bug collector. That's fine. You need to go catch two more, dude. That way you can have your Beedrill and your Butterfree, and you got both lines complete. Oh, wait, can Mega Butterfree please get a Mega? I was watching a video earlier. I don't remember who it was, but someone was talking about top 10 Megas for Gen 8, assuming they bring back Megas. Please bring back Megas. Like, legit. Please. I almost dropped my remote. Please bring back Megas. We need them. We need some new Megas. Mega Evolution actually made it really cool, and it gives some less, like, competitive mons. It makes them actually competitive. It makes them really cool. So I would love to see some new Megas. Pull up a list of the Pokédex here and talk about... Whoops, that's not what I meant to do. Why did you default to that screen? Because you're not supposed to default to that screen. Pokédex. I have too many Pokémon. Searched related to Pokemon, so I can't find, or I can't just, like, pick one. Alright. Serby. National Dex. I'll start scrolling through that while we take down these. So. Well, first off, Butterfree needs Mega. If Beedrill gets one, Butterfree should get one. They're a pair. I agree with that. That was mentioned in that video. Butterfree definitely needs one. I think Fearow should get a Mega. If Pidgeot gets one, Fearow should, because they're kind of the link birds in this game. I think that would make them, or make Fearow a lot better. Butterfree being bug flying is fine. I agree with that, Delta. I think bug flying's fine. I'm pulling it up here. Take a look at its base stats here. So it's got 90 in the special attack, 80 in Spidef, 60 HP, 45 attack, 50 defense. Generally, it's what, a plus 100 to the base stats for Mega Evolution. Oh, I should have gotten Zippo. I got really worked up that last episode, because I'm recording continuously. I got really worked up with the anger there. So I'm a bit yawny here. It's plus 100, isn't it, if I remember correctly? Well, let me go look at Charizard. That's an easy one to look at. So Charizard's base stats are 534, 634, 634. Yeah, so it's plus 100. So, if we got 100 EVs to work with here, I would probably say, well, in abilities, compound eyes or tinted lens, I think, what's its move pool look like? Well, it'd be a good ability for it. Move pool. Actually, it doesn't have a very good move pool. Um, Oh, I'm looking at the Let's Go. That's not what I want. I wanted this one. Thank you. It actually has a very terrible move pool. No wonder it doesn't have a Mega Evolution. Wow, no wonder it, didn't get an evolution. It's just got terrible moves across the board. I think just leave Tinted Lens then. Just let this be a Quiver Dance setup sweeper, type of thing where, you boost, 45 into the special attack, so it's at base 135, putting it on pretty decent terms. Give it, take it to base. Bump its speed 10, so there we're at 50 boosted. 30 into defense, there's 80, and 20 into HP. 100? Yeah. Something like that. Just give it all around, make it super offensive from a special attacking standpoint. Decent speed, so it'd be about the same speed as Mega Gyarados. Actually, what is Gyarados's? Gyarados is base 81, I believe, but what's its attack stat? When it Mega Evolves. I'm scrolling down to it here. Mega Gyarados. Attack is 150, so it's not quite as big of a buff, but it's still a decent buff. Tinted Lens is fine. Everything's basically becomes a neutral hit. I'll have to Quiver Dance set up type of thing, but not being too broken. I could see it being a tier C. If you did it in draft league, it could be a tier C mega, something like Mega Glalie, Mega Camerupt. Not special in any way, but still there, making Butterfree more viable type of thing. I'm gonna switch because you guys probably were tired of watching that sort of thing. Firo being a mega. Kenai and Sniper. Actually, I think Sniper would be a pretty good mega ability for it. Boost its attack 40, so it's at base 130 attack. Maybe a 10 boost in the speed, so it becomes a base 110. So actually, let's give it 50 attack. That's 60 EVs used. And then distribute the remaining 40. Just go 10, 10, 10, 10 in each HP attack, special attack, and speed up. So this thing just becomes a fast attacker. It's still semi-frail. Gets a sniper. I think that'd be fine for Mega Hero. Maybe, let's see. Stop with the Let's Go as the default, please. I mean, throat chop. Yeah, I wouldn't change its typing either. I'd leave it flying, flying normal or normal flying with. Flying normal with Sniper as its ability. It has access to focus energy, so it can be really good with crits. Make it super attack heavy, buff its speed one, but it's still frail, on the frail side. But all around, it could be a pretty decent mon. So there'd be those two for sure. I think should get them. I don't think Arbok needs one. Raichu got an Alolan form. Raticate doesn't need one. Sandslash got an Alolan form. Nidoking, Nidoqueen, I don't think need them. Clefable doesn't need it. Clefable actually stands out pretty well. As far as I can't touch you. Nidoking and Nidoqueen pretty much stand on their own, just like Clefable does. Ninetale got, that's not good. They stand out on their own, so they really don't need a Mega Evolve to do anything. Like Clefairy, or Clefable's generally a tier 1 in most draft leagues. Nidoking and Nidoqueen are sufficient enough in my mind that you don't really have to Mega Evolve them. I mean, Nidoking and Nidoqueen would be really cool to see Mega Evolve. Like, I've seen some great, and there's the crit. I've seen some great, artwork for Mega Nidoking and Queen, but I just don't think we need it. Ninetales doesn't really need it because of, what am I trying to say here? Along with Ninetales, so there's no real need for that thing to get, Omega. Wigglytuff, even if it got a Mega, I just don't see it being, I guess Wigglytuff. Nah, let's not give Wigglytuff one. I don't think that'd be great. I mean, if you did, you could give it Pixelite and that, but I don't know. I'm just, Butterfree and Fearow definitely need them just to make their pairs, but I don't think anything else so far in Kanto really does. Plus, Kanto's got a lot of them. Vileplume doesn't need one right now. Parasect doesn't need one. Venomoth doesn't. Dougie got a different form. Persian got a different form. Golduck got a different form. Primate might be kind of cool if we had a Mega Primate. That's Primates. Actually, Mega Primate would be cool. I'd be down for a Mega Primate. Let's see, it has Vital Spirit, Anger Point, and Defiant. What if we had Mega Primate and gave it Sheer Force instead? Yeah, let's give Mega Primate. I actually think that would be kind of cool. Mega Primate with Sheer Force to make it move. It'd basically be extremely, extremely physically broken. Buff it 45 into the attack stat. Make it base 150, same as a Mega Gyarados. Give it 5 in the speed, so it's a base 100 Mega now. So that's 50 right there. Give it 25 in HP. Give it 25 in defense. Because it's, that would take it, that'd make it much, no, give it in its Spidef. No, give it to it in its defense. Yeah, give it to his defense, that way it can take on flying types a little better, but psychic types can still run up on it. Sheer Force, Mega Primate. That would be pretty clean. Especially with the monster attack stat and base 100 defense, or speed, would put it in a nice tier. It'd be almost as, it'd be like Mega Charizard but without D-Dance. Mega Charizard X, but without D-Dance, basically. It's got a great move pool. Not the Let's Go. I don't want to look at Let's Go. I mean, it's got a great move pool. Cross chopping. Close combat off of that. Has Outrage too, which would be kind of cool. It's got access to Work Up. It does not have any speed boosting things, luckily. But, I mean, you can imagine, like, Work Up or, like, does this get SD? It does not actually get SD, so it's not completely broken, but, it gets the punches, for coverage. Yeah, actually, it could be really cool. Plus, it has access to priority, base 150 attack priority moves. Would be very, very strong. For design, like, I don't know what to do for it for design. Maybe make its fists a little bulkier, put chains on its bands, just, I don't know, something to make it a little more physical, a little more, like, I don't know, just something to make it a little more intimidating. I wouldn't give it intimidate, though. I think sheer force would be beautiful for that, as far as Omega would go. We're going to finish up this battle. I know I didn't make a lot of progress. Kind of just a chill episode here after the last episode where I got really, really frustrated with this game. So, but Primeape's usually like a tier 4, tier 5 type mon. Giving it a mini evolution would definitely, in my mind, be very good. It'd probably take it into tier 2 Mega, maybe tier 1. Kind of straddle that line like Gyarados does. Because in some leagues I've seen Mega Gyarados be a tier 1 mon, and in some leagues I've seen Mega Gyarados be a tier 2. Poison resist fighting, so we just stay sparky. So I think that'd be actually pretty cool to have. I'll talk about some more megas here in the next couple episodes. This is a good talking point. Plus, it's relevant because I have a Mankey on my team. And Primeape's actually one of my favorite mons. I think it's probably my favorite fighting type, or close to being. It's definitely my top 5 favorite fighting types. And it doesn't have to be pure fighting. Like, what's Mankey's doing cool? Oh, I closed it. It doesn't have to be pure fighting. It could be pure fight. Actually, just keep it pure fighting. That's fine. Pure fighting, Mega Primeape. I think that'd be pretty cool. So, with that being said, I'm going to wrap this episode here. If you guys want to leave a comment down below about what you'd want to see is, like, some new Megas, I can touch about some, not obviously in the next few videos, because I'm both recording, but I'll come back to them and take a look. Please check out the links in the description down below, the Twitter, the Twitch, the Discord. Discord's the best way to hang out with me outside of these videos. Follow me on Twitch if you're going to follow me anywhere between Twitter or Twitch. Go follow me on Twitch. I'll get back to streaming eventually. Go show Griffin some love. He's the amazing artist that did all the artwork for my channel, the layout, everything you see, all the layouts. They're all done by him. Go show him some love for me. With that, I'm going to get out of here. See you guys next time.